I just ran across one of your videos. The title just resonated with me. And that is, what is the purpose behind the pain?
Did you push record?
Thank you so much for joining us today on Second Act TV. Today, our focus returns to living your best life after 50, and I'm so happy to welcome Kristin Kaufman to Second Act. Kristin, thanks so much for joining me again.
Thank you for inviting me. I'm delighted to be here, especially in the days of COVID.
Well, I'm so glad to have you. You've been, of course, on before. Kristin is the CEO and founder of Alignment, Inc., and she's the author of 3 fabulous books. Is this seat taken? Kristin, I have all of them right here.
Wow, great. Thank you.
I still reference them every now and then. They are filled with inspirational stories from different angles to really help you live an authentic, purposeful, meaningful life. Now, I always love talking to you, and I'm so glad that I just ran across one of your videos, one of your YouTube videos. You also have a YouTube channel. I'll link to that for our viewers. But the title just resonated with me, and that is, what is the purpose behind the pain? And that so many people, you know, as you say in your video, are going through so much pain right now with what is happening in life, period, but especially also as we age. And I recently did a video on discouragement. And again, tons of comments. People are there. They want to snap out of this. Kristin, talk to me about that. What is the purpose behind the pain?
Yes. You know, I think all of us are seeking a rationale because let's face it, 2020 was a really hard year. I mean, even with the pandemic alone was hard. But I've had other friends, and I'm sure you have too, Silky, that they've lost their jobs. Children graduated from college, graduated from high school, did not get accepted to the college that they wanted. I have a very dear friend who was diagnosed with ALS. Mm. I've had friends who are declaring divorce. In fact, today, Melinda and Bill Gates declared that they're divorcing. You know, just all of this hardship over the last 12 to 18 months. And we're all looking for a reason. You know, why is this happening to us? You know, and I don't think there is ever a reason why these things happen. But I do think they are happening for us, not to us. And I'm choosing to believe that. I'm choosing to believe that. What am I supposed to be learning from these experiences?
Yeah. Well, you came up with three great points. And talk to me about that. Because I do like to have a reason when things aren't going right. It helps to know that maybe there is some purpose behind it. So
yes. So I had 3 things. And these actually came to me probably in my state of depression. I was, you know, trying, like I'm sure many of your listeners, you're struggling. So the first one that I came up with was, well, maybe these hardships are testing my resolve. They're testing my belief. Because I think, for example, I'll give you a personal example. As you know, Silky, one of my main revenue streams in my business is keynote speaking. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, when COVID-19 happened, those conventions went up like a poof of smoke. And therefore, that entire business channel for me dried up overnight. Mm-hmm. And I was thinking, wow, I'm being really tested. I had to really, as my mother used to say, pull myself up by my bootstraps to figure out, well, how am I going to continue to contribute in the way that is authentic to me when I can't be in front of 50,000 people on a stage? So it tested my belief. Is this truly something I really want to do? And it almost always comes down to how badly you want it. And so it tested my resolve. It tested my belief. And therefore, I began to seek other ways to get my message out, right? Mm-hmm. In a virtual world. So that was the first thing.
I actually was lucky in that regard because I've been home-based. But I know so many people what am I going to do with my life? And they found, those with a positive attitude, found a new direction and are like blissful, but then many others are still, you know, in pain.
Right. Well, you know, I probably am one of those. Many of your listeners will resonate with this. I don't think we're going to ever go back to the world as it once was. I really don't. So I think those of us who have tested our resolve, tested our belief, had to kind of, I hate the word pivot, but pivoted in this arena, we found another way to offer our services and to contribute in the world. And I think it's going to be the new normal. And so the sooner we can shift our mindset and grab onto that, the better off we're going to be. If we fight it, you know, that wonderful adage, what you resist will persist. And I just believe that that's true. Yeah. So that's the first lesson. It tested my belief. It tested my resolve. It forced me to reinvent how I take my products and services to market. And I don't think I'll ever go back to what it once was.
Yeah.
It'll always be a hybrid. Always be a hybrid.
Yeah. Well, and that brings us to your second point. You know, what right. is the lesson? What is this teaching us? That's always right. good question.
Yeah. And I have to believe there is a lesson, right? So I think that's the second reason why these things happen to us. My mother used to always say, whatever you're going through today is preparing you for what is to come. And that is so true. Because when the hardest and the ickiest things have happened to me in my life, and I was never one, because I wasn't reared this way, to say, why me? Why is this happening to me? But I would say, what am I supposed to be learning from this? And lo and behold, 2, 3, 5, 10 years later, I'll look back on that situation and go, wow, that's where I learned that lesson. And I can apply it now. So I think what this scenario, these last 12 to 18 months have taught me, it taught me my resilience. It taught me my chutzpah. I mean, I know I've got chutzpah. It taught me that nothing's over till it's over. So I can absolutely take whatever reality I'm facing and I can make the most of it. It always comes down to how badly, as I mentioned before, how badly you want it. And if I wanted to throw in the towel, my goodness, Sylvia, I could have thrown in the towel. But I didn't want to throw in the towel. Yeah. I wanted to find a new way to offer what I do. And that was the big lesson for me.
Yeah.
There's always another way. Always.
Yeah. No, I like that. And I know that you didn't talk about it in this regard, but I always, you know, what comes up for me is also the whole thing with relationships and people right. in your life and what this has taught us, you know, to let go of certain people. I know this, that's a message that you have in one of your books too.
Yeah.
But you really, yeah, we were taught on many different levels, both in business, career, life, and relationships, I think.
Yes. Yes. I agree with that. And, you know, our job is to pay attention.
Yes.
Right. That's our job, is to pay attention. So that's that. And then the third point and the third big aha that I think I had, and this is, again, not always easy, especially when we became couch potatoes and we became homebound, right, is that it trained us to be disciplined. It trained us to be disciplined. And because, you know, when you're not getting up, I haven't gone up and gone to work for 16 years because I, like you, did work out of my home. I didn't work. I didn't go into a brick and mortar office. But when the world kind of stopped, frankly, and it did, it definitely took on a different rhythm. Maybe it didn't stop altogether, but the rhythm was different. It made us look within ourselves and say, I can either get disciplined or I can just fall completely apart. And there are so many clients that I work with that honestly teetered on that, I'm going to fall apart. You know, there was no one holding them accountable. They had to hold themselves accountable, right? They had to get disciplined in themselves. And that sounds really easy, except in the 18 months that we've been at home, not able to go out, sequestered in our four walls. And you have to really dig yourself deep to get back into your discipline, right?
Yeah.
Whatever that looks like to you.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I saw it with a lot of friends. I feel really lucky in that regard because I've been doing this, you know, for years and years and years, like kind of like you. And I need to say, I mean, I have so much respect for you, Kristin, because you're a woman who made it, you know, to the top of the corporate ladder. You ran billions of dollars of budgets, and you know, so your opinion is you know, not that you have to be that successful to have an opinion, but it really matters. It matters to me, and that's why I'm so happy to have you here, and you know, give us your words of wisdom to make us think about our life again.
Oh, that's so nice. You know, I don't know whether they're words of wisdom, but I will say that they are words of authenticity.
Yeah. Yeah.
because I have worn those moccasins. I'm wearing them just like y'all are. You know, I mean, let's face it, the last 12 to 18 months have been difficult for everyone in varying degrees and for varying reasons. And, but it's as my mother used to, I quote my mom and dad a lot. They're neither one with me anymore. They both passed away in the last 2 years. But, you know, you look back at what your parents have told you, and I do it all the time. And mother used to always say, you know, whether you can or whether you can't, you get to choose, you know. And it's, I think it was Henry Ford that actually made that quote so famous. But it is the truth. We own it. All of this SH1T that is surrounding us right now, you know, it is our choice of how we respond to it. We don't get to choose what's happening to us, but we certainly can choose how we respond to it. And that's the only option we have, really.
Yeah. I love that. I was just going to say, we're starting to come to the end of the segment. How would you end it? I don't know that you can end it much better than that.
Oh, gosh. Well, I have to believe that 2021 is going to be a great new year for us. Can you believe we're almost halfway through it
No.
already? I mean, my goodness. And I have to believe, and I pray, honestly, that we in the human condition have learned from these experiences, these last 12 to 18 months of experiences. We've learned them individually, and we've learned from them collectively. And I pray that we will all be better for it. And I truly do believe that we have that potential. I really do believe that.
I do too. We have to believe that. Kristin, thank you so much for talking to us again. I love having you on, and there's some other videos that I might even want to talk to you about, but I will link to your channel so our viewers can you know, get a taste of that directly. Also the books. I love your books.
Oh,
I mean,
you.
Even Stephen Covey here, you know. Endorsed.
Well, bear my heart and soul, that is for sure. I certainly did bear my soul in that last one for sure.
Absolutely, absolutely. Kristin, thank you. And hopefully we'll talk to you soon again on Second Act TV.
I would love it. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. If you haven't already done so, please be sure to subscribe to our channel. And if you have a topic that you'd like to have us cover, visit our website, secondact.tv. We have a little red suggestion box on the upper right-hand corner of our site. Just click on that, send us an email. We'd love to hear from you. See you next time.